And
we live from Fort Worth.
Are we alive?
We are alive. We are kicking. We're making it. All right. Cool.
Just want to make sure that shit was running. We got it rocking now. Crack a Red Bull open. Sponsor us.
You don't drink Big Red.
Then fuck you. Okay. All right, so we're back.
I'm still dropping.
You are?
Yeah.
I'm not even connected to anything.
I haven't been able to pull up the stream yet.
Stream's looking good on my end.
What is our internet called?
AT&T
999
GITI.
Okay.
Atlanta. Yeah. Okay. Might just use my cell phone tonight.
Okay. Yeah. So I think everything's holding up well right now.
Can you get on D&D Beyond?
It wasn't letting me, but
see how it goes this night.
Shoot, I don't want to refresh mine. I might get kicked out of it.
See if the chat room works for me.
Yeah, I'm having a hard time connecting to chat, but the stream's looking good so far.
It is good. It's having some weird issues. But it happens. As long as stream health stays okay, which it's looking good right now.
Yeah.
I think we'll be alright. So,
are you ready to play Dungeons & Dragons, motherfucker?
I don't know. I'm scared.
You should be.
Oh.
Now I really am.
Nate wakes up from his nightmare.
I'm just kidding.
Somebody peed my pants.
Who did these? Okay, so last time, y'all did your downtime. For the course of this downtime, Nate and Draven went to Driscoll. Driscoll went to have a conversation with Frenick. It was very tense and heated. War was threatened.
Very revealing.
Draven wanted to see if Frenick would be forthright about their secret workings, and he was not. So Draven in turn threatened war, but then made the bold claim that they had not been working on their military at all.
Yeah.
That was a good way to get him.
Good card to play.
Sorry, I'm just busting your balls.
Maybe it's a bluff.
It was a very good RP conversation. It was fun. I enjoyed it. Then Nate set up some more drug trafficking, trading some Dream Lily for the Traveler's Dust. Take it down the Crimson Road.
Try to get a Zer hooked.
Try to get a Zer hooked later on. Then Remy and Azur went to go check out the ruins of Sable, see how all that was going. Looks like they've been moving along pretty well, like they're actually starting to put some structures back together. Still a lot of rubble here and there, but you know, they're working.
Well, it's not the workforce.
But you didn't see a lot of people, and you heard some noise. Decided to investigate. It turns out it was a man who was hiding. He told you that some orcs had taken the workers. So y'all decided to help him out because he asked you to help him because they had taken his wife and daughter. So y'all tracked down this party of orcs, found them camped out in a cave a few days north, and you know, they had a very distinct door frame from Sable slapped up against the entrance to their cave. You saw two orcs out front. Y'all decided to fly over to a better vantage point because as you were walking, you fell in, or almost fell into some pit traps. Or you did fall.
We did fall in one.
So y'all flew. got up on top of the cliff, made one orc appear to shit himself. The other one got mad at him, and while they were distracted, y'all killed him. Shouldn't have shit himself. Then other orcs came outside, y'all fucked them up. Then y'all jumped down and tried to attack the leader. And none of your spells could get through. None of your bullets could get through. And he was just tossing this cube in his hand. Eventually, y'all convinced him that you were his friend and he should join you. So he came outside. And he actually caught wind that y'all were up to no good. And that's when he turned around. He told you he forgot something in the cave. He was 100% going back in there to press the button again. But Remy shot the cube out of his hand and Azur banished him. You snatched the cube. You told all of the people to run and attack the wiener. And as you went sprinting across, or y'all went flying across, all the people began to sprint across this valley and they started falling in the pit traps.
I didn't feel bad until you told me what I didn't get in the treasure.
And then... at the end of it, thanks, Soup.
Big Soup Dog.
Nice.
3 months. Fuck yeah. So y'all checked about what there was 35 of them, maybe like 15 made it. Noticed the wife and daughter were dead, so y'all did not go back to Sable and decided to go right back to Blackmore, where y'all met up. You told each other of the things that you learned. At the end of this downtime, some of your Federation missions came to fruition.
Oh, we stole a wagon and guns.
Oh, yeah, y'all did steal the wagon and guns. I forgot about that, yeah.
Our mission was successful.
Yours was successful.
Highly successful.
Y'all took down... y'all fucked them up. Held them, chain lightning to them. Oh, axed and lich. Ooh. Thanks, bro.
One upper.
Wow.
For 4 months. Ooh.
Wow.
Wow.
For four. What you got on that, Johnny?
You got one Corona year on you.
What Corona year? Give you 6 months initial survival.
Nice. Twitch Prime. So y'all stole the guns. You just distributed them amongst the Derringers, amongst your spy guys, the Black Parade,
the Black Shadows, or the
Black Eyes.
All right, let me look it up.
It was the.
Yep.
I can't even watch the stream. It was the Black Prisms.
The Black Prisms. No spoilers.
Black Whisperers.
That was what... You know,
oh, no, not Dropbox. Fuck off.
I think it was
the Black Whispers. It was the Black Whispers. That is it. What was that?
Not a whisper.
Oh! Woo! Got some bits to one up you, Tone. Said, suck my balls, Axton.
You ain't shit.
I can't even get on the stream right now. So I've tried. It won't let
excuses.
Me.
Got some bitties. That makes him way better.
If you bit sorry. This wiener.
Sorry, Axton. Ooh.
Nom, nom, nom.
So, we pick up with y'all in Blackmore. Oh, yeah, you learned of... you got a little information on that robe that you're trying to find. Learned of the Sea of Night.
Yep.
And this crackpot theory that it... There might be something beyond the material plane above.
We shan't learn of it.
But... You pick up... Where are y'all going? I assumed y'all were going to... Driscoll, right?
Going to Borba.
Oh, Borba. The Orcish Whore.
To the Literarium?
Yeah, I got it.
So you make your way to the Literarium. What are y'all doing?
I guess I'll go with... Are you going to go to the same one I?
I think we need to come up with a plan.
All right, later, Sue. Thanks for coming.
We should, if we want to...
Appreciate it, man.
Like, try to start turning the Eye and the King of Driscoll against each other and see what might be the best way to do that, or a way to do that.
Yeah.
So maybe we're gonna sit at a tavern while he goes to read books to figure out what to do.
Yeah, yeah.
Well, I can't read.
True that.
He's reading.
Can't read.
You're not on the planning sesh.
I was gonna go to the magistrate.
Yeah, so what do you want to do with the magistrate?
Go talk to him. Bring a body with me. Did you need a snack?
What would make you want to go back down in that hole?
No reason.
Do you want to try to kill him?
No. It'd be pretty cool, though.
Maybe that's what we do. Frame somebody for a murder.
You kill the magistrate and tell the single eye that
the phrenic did it.
That you care.
I would, I don't know, mate. I think they would. Or we can, that'd be cool. we can bribe,
Borba?
Maybe Borba.
We need somebody to put in Frenic's place.
Yeah.
That's what we need. We need somebody that we can sell these people on.
Got some dirt on.
Yeah.
We've got a lot of dirt on Frenic as it is.
Right.
But he don't seem to want to play ball with our trusted leader.
You think they'll let a bird run the town?
A bird?
Yeah, a bird. Freddy's bird.
Ciro.
Ciro ain't running shit.
Ciro's gonna be
Ciro's useless.
You're just a mouthpiece, King.
He demands 100,000 grain.
I think we need to go to the thing. I think you need to go to the Sanguine Eye and ask what the strengths are for this magistrate to even be alive for them and see what they say.
I don't know if I want to tie us to the murder of the magistrate.
Right, I mean, they're going to know we did it if something happens.
But if that's going to hurt you, though, then we don't kill him. You know, if
he's branched out on his own.
I'm assuming I'm not here for this conversation.
No, you already went off to the library.
The whole point, I think we need to lead them to a decision without telling them what to do kind of thing.
Right.
You know what I mean?
Right. What can coax them into making a move?
Do they know about all the shit he's doing underground? Do we tell them?
The same way.
Gave
her
solder
for
plans for the tunnel, like the layout.
Maybe.
And told her some things.
So
do I know how many people were around that place when I went in there?
He's going for a power grab, or?
You mean?
But,
when I went to the magistrate
talked
early.
To her about it, she's like, well.
Like a year ago?
As long as.
Oh, when you went down there?
Yeah, was there like. How many, like.
You remember from when you went. I believe there were a few guards up front, not very many. It was in that old courthouse.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe if you got that cousin of his hooked on the harder shit.
Yeah.
Just making noise.
Yeah, that's
hooked on the harder shit.
Everything's still working.
Yeah, the stream's still running for me.
No, it's just the soundboard just made a noise.
Oh. Like a click.
Yeah, it was like a. It looks like it's still working though.
Yeah.
Okay.
Ghost is
weird.
Yeah, maybe next time he makes a run for a Borba, we slip him some of the traveler's dust, get him hooked on the harder shit.
Sure.
And
that's your drug dealing.
That's not a bet. I mean,
but
he is a bitch.
Or there was actually when you get there in the room with him, pull the trigger.
Was there was there guards inside of there?
You don't remember there being any.
Because I've been to the magistrate before. There's a few guards outside, but I don't remember being any inside.
Like, wasn't level.
Wasn't level.
He was, pretty powerful, wasn't he?
I mean, facing him one-on-one, I don't think I'd touch him, but...
The strength in numbers.
Alright, so... What are y'all doing?
die tonight, fellas.
Yeah.
All right, so you're going to research.
Yep.
Might need to go help research. Or we're going to start doing some...
Why don't you go research with them?
I'll go research.
Also then... going to store chain lightning into the ring.
What level?
Try to find
actually,
some,
I'll do disintegrate.
Like fire resistance?
Fifth level.
Do you have any of that traveler's dust with you?
Is it six?
Yeah. Oh, give it to Remy.
There's chain lightning above it.
Then I can only do hold monster in there.
So fifth level hold monster?
Yeah.
Pay her to try to get him hooked on it. That can be, and we can address it next time too, to see if it took.
Just give him to her.
Yeah.
All right. So, y'all two are going to research.
Yeah.
And y'all two are.
I'm just gonna run to Borba.
To Borba? Okay. Are you going with him?
Yeah.
Okay.
Is it like a half a day out of the...
Yeah, it wasn't too far.
Okay. I'll give you that.
Okay, so... you make your way to the camp where Borba was. We'll do theirs first, and then we'll do yours. Because, yep. I guess your research will take about a week, so...
Yeah.
If y'all want to... Alright, so you go out to the orc whore camp. as you approach, you notice Borba out front.
Slinging some leg.
Yeah, you see her out by a tree. She has her dress pulled back. She's just taking a huge shit. She sees like you walk up. She's like,
oh. No wipe.
No wipe. Hey, boys. Long hey, time. You looking for a little fun?
I'm hoping you might want to join in a...
Oh, I'm always down to join in.
Business partnership.
I'm following you. Back to my tent.
Oh.
So we got two donors.
A business that doesn't have anything to do with sex.
Was that really business then?
Well, that's not completely true. We use the ruse of sex to get it to where we need it gone.
What is your proposal?
Oh, you want me to finish your story? Okay. So, what we're trying to do is, and we, need in mind, we do have gold.
I like gold.
We're trying to start a little...
I also like dick.
Azure has that as well. We're trying to set up a little sting in the city.
Yeah.
We kind of need to get this. I show her the powder. Or traveler, well, we have traveler's dust, right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, yeah. So it's like a red dust. Powder.
Right. Yeah. Trying okay. to get this to Frenic Driscoll without anyone knowing. Do you still see Frenic on a regular basis?
I see him from time to time. We have a good time. So you want me to give this to him?
In a nice way. If there's anything possible.
Some heavy stuff.
Have you tried it?
I've walked the Crimson Road a time or two.
Oh.
If you know what I mean.
I can tell.
Well, how much are we offering here? It's pricey.
What would something that's like this
you
mean?
You need to give one of the most addictive narcotics to the Lord of Driscoll. We'll go 5,000. Or 3,000 and two dicks.
Deal.
Azir has a thumb.
At the same time.
Both of you.
God damn it.
Or five. Your call.
It's $1,000 a bone.
That's our dicks are worth quite a bit.
Yeah, that's half price, bro.
Yeah. Yeah, y'all are selling high.
she like scratching at her crotch or anything?
Make a perception check.
Yeah, there's things scratching her crotch.
A 14.
Okay, here we go.
She doesn't seem to be actively itching it, but every now and then her hand kind of...
That might be the shit she didn't wipe.
Shoes away the flies.
She's like,
Yeah, she just took a shit and didn't wipe. Yeah.
Yeah, I don't think they have toilet paper here, just like us.
I mean, that saves you 1,000 gold each.
No TP since the Rona.
So, we give you 5,000, and what are you going to... Just give us your plan of how you're going to do this. Just tastefully.
Lady never tells the details. Luckily, I'm not a lady.
You're just going to delicately give him a pinch before.
Borba doesn't do anything delicately.
I figured not.
But I'll give it to him. We'll have a good time.
I believe you.
We'll get him on it.
5,000?
Or 3 and 2 dicks.
I mean, I don't think my friend's here are willing to partake.
I'm trying to talk him into it.
More of the orcish whore is very full.
Are we fucking Borba or not?
Do it.
We might get something we just can't get rid of.
A lot of consequences.
What do I have resistance to here?
Where's
resistance?
The D100?
Yeah, if Borba has my kid, I will not claim it.
You do not have gonorrhea resistance.
We've got a cleric. He can solve it.
Greater restoration.
He's got some penicillin shots.
Got a nature check?
Can't. He's like, oh, boys, that's a bad one. We'll go with I don't know what to do for you other than 5,000
road on this one.
What about 4,000, Borba?
Yeah, what about 4,000?
4,000 and one dick?
Hey. What about your... Where's your best looking... What if I dick someone else
right
now?
Here. Hot stuff.
There's no question Borba's the hottest.
Check my temperature.
God damn it.
Do it.
You don't have to do it.
Oh, I'm thinking of something I could...
It's just her character. She's very forward.
Yeah. I'm walking up here, saw you take a shit and didn't even do anything, so... Maybe another time. Maybe another time after after we get some, you know.
Edward Deepy's admitted.
But thank you.
It's always different. Male orcs for
suit
here.
Yourself.
It's always, you know.
Azir's looking for actually a male orc.
That is not true.
Well,
I've had plenty of
so five,
elf and human ladies.
5,000.
I've already marked it off of my.
See
how Drew gets us to pay full price for once.
Hand her the traveler's dust and the 5 gold.
Yeah, the one time you're not.
I'll also give her some Dream Lily because I got like a pound in here.
Okay.
So I'll also give her some Dream Lily.
So you give her some traveler's dust and
Dream Lily.
Hmm? Start a pusher.
Can't trust them by themselves.
Right.
Okay.
Get her.
We need more customers.
Get more people on it.
You know, it's going to be getting sold here now.
Yeah.
Okay, so. That was awesome.
Whew. That was dangerous.
Yeah.
Let's see if y'all
do we want to follow Borba and make sure she makes it into the fucking town?
Yeah. I think it's past the point.
I just thought Green might go.
Yeah.
Alright, so y'all head back. You too.
Yep.
What do you want to do like the next couple days?
I need to make some bullets.
Okay. So
I'm going to
spend some time doing that. Give me one of your checks.
Going to the.
You're gonna go with him.
Pra's house, the prostitute's house.
Okay.
Now he's all worked up.
Look for a nice orc.
No, like I said, I prefer elves or humans.
Fair enough. They have plenty.
18.
Elves and humans. 18.
Yeah.
All right. I'll say you're able to make another good 40 bullets.
I want to check out, like stories, like even like we thought might be like legends of like people that went to hell and like got back. Like if there's any like old legends or
there
and back
stories,
a hobbit's
like
tale.
What they might have legendary items they may have used or just why they went or just whatever old stories like that.
Okay.
All right, so that's what you're researching.
The Green Knight.
I'm looking into Azil Greymane and the Sea of Night, and I'm going to put 1,000 gold down to help my research.
Okay. All right, so give me your rolls. If it's an intelligence check.
Don't remember.
I can pull up the particulars.
Because I thought there was like a certain modifier.
I think you get like a +3 or something, I think. All right. Let's
see. Sources, Xanthars.
Ooh, hell yeah.
Downtown research.
Way to start off the night.
All right, so research. So you would put down 600 gold instead of 1,000. 600 is the maximum.
Oh, 600 is the max. Yeah. Okay.
And that gives you a +6.
Okay.
On top of it.
Okay.
Normally you make a intelligence check, +1 bonus per 100 gold spend to a maximum of +6.
Okay.
So what'd you get?
You said just the
intelligence modifier. So it's just a roll with your intelligence modifier and then your that +6.
So that's going to be 31.
Okay.
Natural 20.
I'm going to pay 600 also.
Okay.
And 9 plus 15.
15. Okay.
It's going to be worth it.
Yeah.
You must have rolled pretty low.
Rolled 5.
Yeah, I forgot you had those you points called like luck.
It's 15.
You luck a crossbow shot, but you won't re-roll a intelligence check.
I actually did luck it. I rolled a 1 first. That's what you're going to keep talking about it.
Can you mark that down for me?
Done.
Don't need a lifesaver. This one. No, just one.
I'm not gonna
Rona, just one.
Rona pass it to you.
This, all I wanted was one. I don't need a handful.
There's one.
They all flew on
right
OP. So, what was your total, James?
15.
15. Okay, so looking through the most recent thing, or I guess the thing you come up with, it's a newer entry. It mentions a man that traveled there and back. He used the plane shift amulet. So, a wizard by the name of Roland Tilcott.
Tilcott.
That name rings a bell in your head.
Oh.
That is the man who runs the Elder Talisman in Thorley.
Really? Holy shit.
Interesting. That's why he was selling it.
And you.
Yes.
Rogue shop?
Mm-hmm.
He is a strong wizard. And then you, where's this fucking page? Here it is. Okay. So you learn, so Azalea Greymane, during your research, you rolled a 31.
Yeah.
Okay. So there, when she brought all this stuff forward, it was like a long time ago. She brought this information forward, and at the time, the area was run by more of a theocracy. Priests of Almenter and Mistra were more in power, and they held court. She brought this forward. She was declared a heretic and was cast from society, and they cited how she must have gone mad to bring something up like this. Stories talk about her what is this? Oh yeah, within this story too, it mentions that she had a notebook that they used as evidence for her madness. Inside it was said that people might go mad just from looking at it. It was like more of like a Eldritch horror,
yeah,
kind of thing. but it was made of so black leather. It was more of like, you know, just a notebook, not a big book. On the side was said to be filled with like wild scribbles, disturbing images, things like that. Just kind of just fucking like all over the place. This court was held in what's now Driscoll. There is a surviving courthouse that you know of from the time before. Azur's been there.
Oh, shit.
Ruling magistrate.
So, through your research, you learned that this book was locked away in a safe room, and it may still be there.
Anything about the Sea of Night?
Actually, going through your research, there's nothing about the Sea of Night.
Really?
The only information you found on the Sea of Night was related directly to her. And now through this research, you found it was deemed heretical. So
they just, like, wiped it from history.
Yeah, so it's not through any of this history, really.
Holy shit.
Yeah, it seems like she's one of the only people to really bring it forward.
I basically got to get my hands on that notebook now.
Huh. If only we'd ever seen a black book that if you looked at it, you went mad.
It's not a tattoo on your arm, Nate.
I don't know. I think that was a different book.
It was. That's why I was like, no, it's a smaller book. Cause that,
I thought that at first, too. I was like, have I looked at this book?
Yeah, it's not that one. It's just rumors and tales.
Gotcha.
I mean, I'm mad for looking at it. The other one did. There's only one way to find out.
So, we got one problem.
What's that?
We're going to do something really nasty. Two birds, one stone.
Two birds, one stone.
Have you already gone to the magistrate?
You went back to Borba, didn't you?
He does not know he's been fucking whores.
Okay. Then I guess at some point, then I'll meet up with...
Roll this.
Am I going to have a kid again?
Is that...
Am I
32?
See, I think that... Yeah, it's cocked. 78.
So I guess I'll meet up with Azur. And
so at the end of this week, you'll meet up at the tavern, have a couple going back.
Have you gone to the magistrate yet?
No.
Would you still like to visit them?
I look around for anybody that's kind of... I think we should pay him a visit.
I would like to go say hello as well. He has something that I'm quite interested in.
If we're going to actually survive, we might have to take a present.
Present? What do you mean?
You know, Nate.
Like last time.
Yeah.
I'm not sure what either one of you are talking about.
I'm not sure either we're Draven is going to be cool with sacrificing somebody.
The last time I went there, I had to suggest an old homeless man to come with me so he could eat him. I gave him, like, food. I let him sleep in a bed. Like, I gave him a night out in the town.
Does it have to be a person? Couldn't we bring a... I don't know. Is there anything else that you might be interested in?
Human. Preferably live.
So you think if we bring... Each of us bring a person with us that'll keep us safe from him?
Or just things go bad. We might just be like, take him!
And
we can get out of there. Oh, but if we want to go and just fight him, then we probably don't have to take anybody.
Your friend is rather close to him. Would she have any information of gifts that might behoove such a figure?
Yeah,
I can ask
dead, a body.
If they can set up a meeting.
All right, that sounds good.
See how that goes.
But
if something goes south, I don't know if we want to be the ones that are tied to anything happening.
We could always come back. Maybe. I don't know.
What do you mean?
If
What do you want? What are you trying to get in there?
There's apparently a vault somewhere inside that building that contains a notebook from Azalea Greymane that has possible information where her cloak may be.
Well, if you want that, you're going to have to kill him.
I don't know. I think we could be amicable about this. And
no, he's crazy and sane. Very, what is mine type of person, just looking at him.
What if we brought him a really special gift? Say the Lord of Driscoll.
I don't think he's in the...
Do I know anything about beholders?
That sounds like a great idea.
I don't think that there's a way to trade with this guy.
Sounds fun.
You just know, I'd guess, mainly that they're crazy. They're just...
So I would...
They're wild.
I wouldn't know that they're vain characters that chaotic. Like their self-image. Okay.
No. yeah, you just know they're kind of wild.
Okay.
I'm just going to tell you that I don't think a monster like that should even be alive. If I go back in there, I don't know if we're leaving unless he's gone.
I don't necessarily like the idea of it myself, but...
Is there a bunch of soldiers or anybody else in there with him, or he's pretty much just chills by himself?
Yeah, he's a loner type of...
I don't think he needs the protection.
Right,
There's just a few on the outside, if I recall. So...
We plan on taking them out on the way in?
I mean, we could trick them in, maybe. I mean, we could just go in there and tell some lies to get in, but...
Okay. I think that would be better than trying to set up an official meeting.
I don't think we should
try to keep it off the book.
If you go for the book.
I think we should. I just don't want you two to get this getting fallen back on y'all two.
I do believe that
it might be something we
could try to be amicable about it. Maybe do bring a small token of appreciation. You know,
by token, do you mean child?
There's no,
no.
There's no trading or bartering with this thing. Trust me, I looked him in his eyes, and I don't. He just doesn't seem the person that would be. I'll trade you this for that. I think he's more
lucky enough to escape with your life.
Yeah. I mean, I think if I recall, he gave me a pretty good of warning and proving of how lucky I was that he let me actually off. So,
you think we should still bring somebody just to get us through the door?
Well, I think Remy should just look like a homeless man and...
Okay.
Well, yeah. can't say nothing.
Yes, Remy.
No, I just meant because he doesn't cast a spell, right? You can look differently without casting a spell.
Yeah, I just put on a hat.
I thought of something else, but it's not what I'm going to say.
Okay, if I'm dressing up like a hobo, I want another one with me. Is it to defeat this creature, or is it to...
Walk in and start blasting.
That's the plan.
So anyways, just start blasting.
Yeah.
If that's the case, I think we ought to try to just sneak in and not go through the front door, possibly magically through the walls.
I mean, we're going to have people rushing us. I mean, this is going to be pretty loud.
I would assume no one in their right mind would go in that room.
Yeah.
God only knows what sounds come out of a room with a beholder in it.
It was. I followed him to that location the first time.
Yeah, so you can remember where it is.
And I don't remember if it's far enough out of town or is that.
It's in town.
It's in town.
Yeah. See,
it's like in the old lower city.
Could I hear them whenever they were down there from the top?
Could you hear them talking?
Hear him talking or him... I think he disintegrated an old man.
No, you don't remember hearing anything.
Okay.
Because I think the plan should be you go in there, kill him, and then we teleport out. Teleportation circle to the...
Yeah.
If we can.
Do I know if teleportation circle leaves any residue behind once we leave? Any evidence that... Someone might have been there and use an arcane mean to get out.
It does leave a small trace, but it would take someone specialized in detecting that to notice.
Because we kill him, and then we literally, if we can, go just straight to the Federation in Driscoll.
But it wouldn't leave like a...
So
if, like a scourge mark.
Yeah, we're not going to Blackmore or anything like that. We can actually just transport to the Federation in Driscoll. And then we'll still be in town, and you can still go, you know.
That depends if I have anything left after
this.
That's
what I'm saying. If there's anything, if we can't. Yeah. If not, we'll...
This could be quite taxing.
We'll kill everybody in the neighborhood. Children too. That was a joke.
We killed everyone. The women and children too.
But.
So, shall we go tonight or shall we go in the morning?
Is Roussel with us or he's...
Yep.
Roussel, are you okay with fighting a deadly monster from the depths of who the fuck knows where?
I mean...
At this point, it's another day.
to retrieve
another day on the job.
To retrieve a book that sends us to the Sea of Stars or something like that?
Sea of Night.
Sea of Night.
I'm down, though. I said this when we first started discussing.
What up, Heiko?
What up, dude?
I think we destroy the magistrate and then we put billboards everywhere and say...
Fuck the magistrate.
Finnick killed the... Beholder
killed the magistrate.
The Sanguine was hiding.
Unless we had some firearms, we could scatter around the place to look like his soldiers. Maybe we could beat up some of his soldiers and drag them down there.
Alright, so y'all doing this?
But that would take a while, so I think we'll just head down there.
We'll see what we do.
What time did we decide on going down there?
Let's see if we even finish. We might be hitting
nightfall.
Alright, then what time is it now?
Yes. It's about midday.
Okay. I'm gonna rest and try to get a long rest then and go at midnight or something then.
What? You need a long
lounge
rest?
Around all day.
Well, I mean, I can take a short rest. I just, you know, want to be fully prepared for this.
Well, we had a week. We had a full
okay,
week.
I was.
Yeah. That was the end of the
You've
week.
You've had a rest.
I put one down.
Yeah.
You definitely had a rest. Okay, so last time I definitely used the old mat, right?
Yeah. Oh, the OG that I bought.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Yeah, I think so.
All right.
I've never fought one of these before.
Yeah.
No break.
But yeah, let's take. We're gonna take like just a short break.
You
here.
Don't want to miss this.
We will be right back.
Don't want to miss the
Beholder.
A couple things and set up. Should be like 5 minutes.
Don't you dare leave! Thank you.
I like this music. Reminds me of an old RPG.
Forgot to show maneuver.
Looks like your room's actually clean for once.
Yeah, it is clean.
Get a girlfriend and everything changes.
Had to clean it up.
Yep.
I bet the one out in Midland still looks like shit.
No, my room's always clean up there.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Oh. Well, I guess Tone decided not to come back.
I like the mood lighting.
Mm-hmm. He knows where we're headed.
Yeah, this was his idea.
Any day now, sir.
Any day now.
Negative.
He's just trying to get in your pants.
Wow. Like how Tone really kept pace with the group. All the cool kids pee their pants.
Who washes their hands?
You wash your hands with this Rona about? Will you close my door when you pass it?
Oh.
Thanks, Brad.
It's really the only reason we were waiting on you.
Only reason for you to shut up. Yeah, we would have started.
You'll go to sleep, or I will put you to sleep.
After we wait a little bit and we start headed out, I'm gonna put my mask on.
Okay.
Fucking mask on.
Going mask on.
With the mask on.
All right. Okay. So you make your way to.
Like that observes.
I just said everybody down.
So what's up, Maggie?
All right. So you make your way down to the old courthouse. Nate leads you there. Seeing out front, you see those stairs that lead down, and right in front of those stairs are the two guards you remember seeing. Members of the Sanguine Eye.
Just, I'll walk up to one of them. So we've got a meeting with the magistrate.
I wasn't told. Did
it's kind of a spur of the moment.
Okay. So. Make a deception check.
See, he's kind of sitting there like,
Nate wouldn't lie to me.
That is a 29.
Well, if you say you've got a meeting with the magistrate, you must have a meeting with the magistrate.
Yeah. Well, I'm a whole heir of the Sanguine Eye.
All right.
Yes, well. Just came up. Oh, yeah.
Well, go ahead. Hopefully he's in a good mood.
Yes, I hate this. Time.
Well, good luck.
I'll walk down.
Okay. As we get out of earshot of the guards, should we have gone in this way and let them know that we were here last? Or at all?
If they have to disappear, they have to disappear.
Alright, so y'all enter.
We're doing after this.
How
fight.
Do you want your order to be?
I'll go first.
Yeah, you know, you've been down here, so I'll be after him. Yeah, it's good. Yeah.
Okay. I'll be off to the right a little bit. Yeah, that's fine.
Okay. I'll just be right behind Azir.
And then Reese in the back, baby. Can we say we bought a couple of diamonds before we walk down here?
I think we all have.
Yeah, just marked it off.
Well, we just need one more because Remy, we used one on. No, who was it? You.
Yeah.
So we just needed to do one for him.
I thought he had other 500 gold ones, like a couple worth 500.
Oh, we did. I guess he did get, like. I can't remember. I know he's got enough for if one of us goes down.
Yeah, because. Already had one from before, and then he's got the enough for all of us in that other group, so we should have one for all of us. Okay. But if not,
it was just to make sure we had them before we walked down in here. you know.
A little dark.
Yeah, need some light.
You can turn that one on and angle it.
That one's a switch.
I just didn't know if you wanted to try to angle it.
Oh, yeah.
This one? Mm-hmm.
Sweet.
All right. Make your way into the halls of the Mountain King.
Dungeons, dude.
Gotta get ready for this one.
And Valley's low.
All right.
Fuck. As we walk down, I'm gonna cast Mage Armor.
Okay.
Throw up my ward.
Have I had a long rest since we did our investigation? I guess.
Yeah.
So I'm gonna take that luck back.
Oh my god, damn it! I was kinda half serious about killing this guy.
You let us here.
I was blindfolded. Nate let us here.
That's true. What's that distance?
To Azura is 90.
Cool. And then, you know, up. He's up 5, 10, 15, 30, 35.
Okay, so in here you see the old hall is dimly lit. Thrown in the back. You see the magistrate floating above 30 feet in the air. Just looking up, you do notice like about a beholder sized hole circular in the roof.
Are you about to pull a coup and run both gangs? Is that what this is?
I have my own aspirations.
Alright, right as you walk in. Yeah, you see him there. God damn it, I didn't mean to do that. Sorry. I'm trying to open something.
We'll be rolling. I need to look
okay,
into
it.
So, the beholder, kind of looking around, you see his eye stalks just moving around, like kind of all crazy, just spinning around behind him, up, down, just moving, like almost just wildly, just, and he looks up at you. What brings you to, my place?
Oh, we, come to inquire about a journal you might have.
A journal that I might have.
Yes.
And, see some of his eye stalks kind of peek up and almost look like it's trying to look over you.
What gifts did you bring me?
What? You dressed as a,
I have not put on a disguise, no.
Okay. We have that cube.
Yeah.
We've got this wondrous cube here.
What does the cube do?
I really wish we had the cube attuned to one of us now.
Right.
We could have it out right now and you can turn it into it.
What does the cube do? What does the cube do? That doesn't sound right. What does the cube does do?
What does the cube do? Yeah.
What does... Mm-hmm. What... The cube.
This cube does
what
wonderful
the cube
things.
It does what?
You press any corner of the cube.
Press
and
it.
It does something different.
Sure.
Okay. Well, can I even use it if I haven't attuned to it?
No.
I don't know if I have the power to show you here. But if I spend some time with it, I could.
Perhaps one of your companions. No, that doesn't sound. Companions? No. Friends?
what does... Yes. Maybe one of your...
You know, we'll just
comrades.
Step, we'll just step out for an hour and we'll come back and show you.
I want to see it now. What now, if, I want to see it.
What if I offer myself?
You might make a fine meal. Come here and let me eat you.
I'll start walking halfway.
Okay.
I can only go 60 feet.
I was like, all right, sit there and lay down and look like a nice meal. Any, you know, things to make the plate look better? Any garnish?
I spit up in the air and it lands on my
chest.
This is
pretty fucking raw.
Well, before I give myself, will you give us my friends, companions, partners, a journal?
Yes. Get out your pens. Papers?
We were hoping for the actual journal itself.
No.
A specific one.
I thought you wanted the journal of the magistrate.
Would you like us to record your
Yes,
journal?
Papers and pens, please.
I'll to, pull out papers and pen.
All right, write this down.
Hereby on the... Oh, what day is it?
I just say a random
We'll call
day.
It the second day. Ah, no, that doesn't sound right. The first day. 1,000? Sure. 1,001?
Nay.
Of my reign as magistrate. Supreme. Why do they call me the magistrate?
Saying, what do you do?
I magistrate, of course.
How many cases have you magistered over?
You wouldn't even be able to count that high.
Yes, you're probably right.
It's more than 3.
You lost me there.
Well, anyways, yes, on the 1,001st day, the magistrate had a meal prepared. It was a bland plate, just a blue carrot. With some whipped cream on top. looks delicious. Covered in metal could be a problem, but I have razor sharp... Are you writing this down?
Yes, I'm...
Razor sharp teeth could bite right through it. Might add a little crunch. Ooh. I like tire of this journal. Hopefully you enjoy it.
I write it down. Verbatim.
Journal given?
Would you like to see it, sir?
No. I have no interest in journals.
What should be the title?
Oh, of course. The title.
It must be catchy if you want people to read it.
Yes. Let's call it...
You know our simple brains.
Let's call it...
A New Day.
Give them a little twist. We'll call it the Red Meal. It'll throw them off when it turns out it's a blue meal.
That is quite a twist.
It is. I'm an excellent writer.
Put
Anyways.
It away in my bag.
All right, journal for meal. Be gone.
We still need the specific journal we
can
pull.
You know what they say about begging choosers? Wait, choosing beggars? Yes, no. Yeah, that sounds right.
Why would you choose a beggar?
They say they get disintegrated.
Ah, never heard of that one.
No.
Did you make it up?
I did, just now.
That's why I haven't heard it.
Well, should have anticipated it.
I'm not as grand.
Are you plotting against me?
I do not have the intellect to even dare it.
A couple of the eye stalks kind of look over at you. Says he wouldn't dare it. Of course he wouldn't dare it. Why would he dare it? Anyways. Specific journal. You can try to find a journal.
Where will we need to head inside of here?
I would imagine journals are kept in the journal storage bin.
Ooh.
That's where I keep journals.
Is there a doorway behind
him? Yeah, so behind him there is, like, doors on both sides. They're just kind of, like, open passageways. Like, what are those called?
I will just start, sauntering
with
that way.
Towards the same direction.
He just kind of watches you.
What are you doing?
I'm just looking at him.
I will go through the door.
All right. You go through. Which one? Left or right?
Which way to the
journal storage?
The vaults?
Ah, the journal storage, man. That was more of a hypothetical. Hmm.
Just conjecture. You know.
If it were a thing, where might it be?
Ooh, wow. Breaking down the philosophical questions of our time. I don't know if we can ever know the answer. Perhaps I know all the answers. Perhaps you know the answer.
Have you ever?
Do you know the answer? Are you hiding the answer from me?
Have you ever?
And then you see like three more of those eye socks just kind of come over and look at you.
Have you ever heard of the game Hot or Cold?
Yes.
It's where if...
where I light you on fire and then I turn you into ice?
I haven't heard of that one, no. This one's a bit different.
We could play the other one.
Maybe after.
Okay. I'll hold you to it.
Maybe with somebody else.
I want to play with you.
Oh. Maybe this one. If I move closer to the object that we seek, then you say that we are getting warmer. But if we are getting further away, then we are getting colder.
Oh, an interesting concept. Perhaps there's a twist.
I think the twist is if we find a journal.
Ah, okay. Okay, start over there by the food.
I guess we go back to the Azure.
Send over by that blue carrot there. All right.
I'll start walking towards the right door.
Neutral.
I'll walk closer to the right door.
Colder.
Left door?
Start walking in the other direction.
Warmer.
I'll get closer.
Warmer.
I'll get to the left door.
I'm gonna stand back from him.
How close am I to the doorway?
You're right in front of it.
I'm gonna go into the doorway.
Warmer.
Can I see him anymore?
No, you've like walked through.
What is it? What does it look like?
So in this, you see like a long hallway. It's very dark in here. It's not lit. Do you have dark vision? You have
the 60 goggles.
Yeah. So yeah, you can see down 60 foot down. You see just a wall. You see a passageway that turns off to the left, and you see three doors in this room: one on the left side, two on the right.
I'll walk to the first door.
Warmer.
I'll walk to the second door.
Warmer.
I think he's just saying things now, Nathaniel.
I'll walk to the third door.
Warmer.
I'll walk to the end of the hall.
Warmer.
I take the left. I don't actually take the left.
Warmer.
I'm way down at the end of the hall.
Warmer.
There's no more place to go.
Warmer. I hit him with the twist. I said warmer instead of colder.
I peek around the doorway.
I think it's on the right side. And I'll go into
colder.
The thresh way of the right-hand door and just hide against the wall.
Colder!
I'll walk out with my head shaking and walk towards the other door.
Okay. At this point, he floats down and he goes to grab you with his teeth.
Is his back turned towards me?
Yeah.
I'm going to try to cast whole monster on him.
Okay.
Through my ring.
All right, so fifth level, and that is what save?
That is a wisdom save, I believe, which probably is not going to fucking work on him.
Yeesh. He's not very wise. He's dumb-dumb.
Dumb-dumb, why gum-gum?
All right, wisdom.
Yeah, because he's going to have advantage with this bite.
One.
I'm just trying to not let him get a free attack on you.
26.
Yeah, he fails.
All right, roll initiative.
advantage on initiative. I rolled a 20 and a 1.
I'm good for you.
All right, 25, 20.
25.
24.
Let me just start this fight.
19,
15. 19. Fucking damage.
What'd you get, Azir?
4.
So I can't even stand up.
So I'm guessing he's down here by Azir?
Yeah, he was just coming towards him. So he's still flying over. He's above. So put him just like right there, yeah.
Excuse me.
He was just like flying closer with his teeth. All right, so starting this combat off against the magistrate, we got Remy up.
I'm going to move.
And now we'll pull out old trusty pepper box.
Okay. Alright.
And shoot him, hopefully, in 3 eyes.
Alright, where are you at? Okay, so.
Over here. Okay, trying to go kind of behind the pillar.
Okay. Alright. So, when you roll to hit, don't add the +1 to hit from the pepper box. Just so you know. So, like, it'll show your roll to hit, -1 on it.
Holders.
To look at that. 28, 22, and 28.
All right, all 3 hit.
He's dead. Got him.
He's dead.
And he just explodes! Alright, so you step out, you fire 3 shots. All 3 slam into his hide. And now it's Nate's turn.
And he's up in the air.
Right before your turn, though. Let's see. He's going that way, so. He will target Draven with one of his eye rays as a legendary action.
Yeah.
Fuck. So random.
Where is everybody at? Is Nate even in here yet?
Yeah.
You're just in under the doorway.
Yeah. All right. Draven, make a dex save.
That probably does not pass.
What is it?
11.
11, yeah, that fits. Take 50 points necrotic damage as this just red and black ray fires out of one of the eyes and slams into your chest.
Ouch. Good thing I had that ward up.
So 55. Did you mark it?
Yeah.
Okay. And all right. Now it's your turn, Nate.
Okay.
Fuck. Basically, behind, yeah.
hold my action to if he gets in range to hit him with my saber.
Okay. So you're ready your saber. That'll end your turn. At the end of your turn, he'll use one of his legendary actions to target you with an eye ray.
Ah.
He's got these eye stalks up so he can see all over the place.
Like the mini.
That's freaking cool.
I gotta see what ray it is first.
Yeah. Don't be disintegrate.
Alright, so give me a dex save.
Seventeen.
That passes. Since you passed, you take no damage, right?
Correct.
Okay. Yeah. So you see this green ray fly out of one of his eyes, and you're just able to just completely dodge out of the way. As it hits the stone behind you, you notice that stone just gets turned into dust.
Oh no. Yeah. That plus nine is clutch.
Yeah.
Alrighty, and. Now on his turn, he will so this does alright, so here he will looking down, he'll close his eye. And he's gonna fire a ray at you, a ray at you, a ray at you. So the first one at Nate. Give me a wisdom save, Nate. The second one at Azure. Give nice. Me a deck save. And the even. Third one at Draven.
Nat 20, that plus.
Give me a constitution save.
A nat 22.
20. What'd you get?
24.
Don't like that.
That's a lot better.
Yeah, I next wanted it.
That is 22.
22, okay. Alright, so you'll take half damage.
No, I got it. Chill Master.
Chill Master, so you take no damage. Mm-hmm. Okay, so you take no damage. see this green ray fly at you. You just kind of turn out of the way, holding your shield up. It goes right across it.
I'm glad I get advantage on these.
Yeah. Thank God.
You saw an orange ray come at you. You dodge out of the way. And what is this one? Purple comes at you. And you avoid it.
We're getting lucky. We're getting lucky, nice. Gentlemen.
Alright. Keep up the good rolls. And at the end of his turn, he's going to open his eye again. And... Draven, you're up.
Alright, I'm gonna pull forth static from the air, and I'm gonna toss a synaptic static
at him. That is a intelligence?
Yes.
Uh, 25.
Passes. And then I'm going to tuck myself behind that wall right there.
Okay.
What wall?
Oh.
Where that doorway is right here.
Okay. It's just an open threshold.
Oh, I thought that
goes into a hallway.
Oh, okay. Then I'll, is there that chair actually there?
Yeah.
Okay, then I'll, get behind that chair.
Okay.
Use this cover.
Alright, make a con save.
Is a raise coming at you?
He's up.
Go. That is 19.
Alright. That is two looks.
All right, you pass. Half as much.
Legendary resistance. That's what freaking it is. Cheaters.
Luck
cheaters.
Saving my ass.
Yeah, cheaters. No kidding.
Cheaters.
Well, we got it.
Bunch of cheaters.
I don't want to die.
Sorry, none of us have a shield that made us immune to all magic.
It doesn't make you immune at all.
So you take, after it's half 16 points 16. Of necrotic damage, this more like greenish yellow ray comes at you.
All right.
Get you, make you a little sick to your stomach.
What?
You feel a little energy sapped out of you.
And now it's Russell's turn. So I should open his character sheet, huh?
He wets his chain mail.
He leaves.
It rusts.
Russell Damon.
So far, I haven't been able to find anything that he can't easily pass.
Yeah, it's going to be a struggle.
All right.
I've tried intelligence. I've tried wisdom. I haven't tried dex yet.
All right, Russell's going to try to cast Guiding Bolt, and nothing happens.
Do I see that?
Make a perception check.
Which I'm laying down. I don't know if
I guess disadvantage.
I cannot see it because I'm behind a throne.
18.
18. So yeah, you just see out of your corner of your eye, you see him, something you've seen him do many times, and he goes to cast it, the spell, and kind of snuffs out. All right. All right there, so Draven, another ray coming towards you. This one is a 14. Wisdom save.
I gotta like this one.
Third look.
Fucking one, yeah. Natural 20. Total of 27.
All right, yeah, you pass. As this orange ray flies at you, you just duck back under the chair. Flies over.
That's all my lux.
Azure.
Stand up.
Yep.
Stand up.
Next to you. And defend her still today.
You know. I'm just going to try to Eldritch Blast on.
Alright, so you got to cast Eldritch Blast and you go. And everybody hears you make the sound effects that you normally make that get covered up by the noise. Nothing happens.
Oh, you were making those noises.
Normally it's like pew pew pew. That you like make the sounds too.
Kelly Holmet or whatever her name is. What's the name? Holly Holmet.
Yeah, so you try to cast your spell and nothing happens.
Problem's getting it up, is there?
And look at the legendary action again after even.
Oh my god!
Give me a con save.
Not so lucky anymore, are ya?
Okay, that's good. That is 19.
19, okay, you passed. That's a purple ray just flies over.
You seem like, motherfucker!
The luck hasn't run out yet.
Yeah.
So as soon as you step out to shoot, don't do the minus one again on your to hit.
Yeah, I got you. I'm going to shoot once. 25.
That hits.
I'll go ahead and shoot two more times then. 25 and an 18.
All three hit.
I knew Bermuda was going to be our best one in this matchup.
Alright,
Nate, you're up.
Alright, I'm gonna yank out my crossbow and I'll take a shot.
Alright.
Crossbow warning. 15 plus 9 to hit.
That'll hit.
1d6. I guess I can use my... No, no one's around him. For 9 points of damage.
Alright.
And I'll go ahead and... use a bonus action to try to do something.
Okay.
I'm going to cast a mind thrust as a bonus action.
All right.
Intelligence save.
Okay. What the hell?
Fuck, I don't know. Fuck. You're like...
They got verbal components.
Triangle vein in it, and it pops up. Then you fall over and your feet get straight up in the air.
Oh no!
You cast it on your shelf.
You done?
A pan yes. falls from the sky.
Right. So now he's going to.
I knew I'd have trouble with this guy. This is our song now.
Hopefully, didn't come too early.
Don't. No! You some bitch.
So he floats over and then turns around.
Fuck.
And at this point, he's gonna send two eye rays at you and one at Roussel. So.
Watch out, Rose!
We'll do one at you, one at Roussel, and then one at you again, just to make it easier. All right, so the first one at you, give me a wisdom saving throw. The one at Roussel.
Me, right? Not Remy, right?
No, two at Remy.
Yeah.
Me?
Oh, yeah. Oh, I thought you were doing me. Oh, nice one. Hell yeah.
22 on the wisdom save.
Okay, so you pass that one, Roussel's.
Okay, he's gonna do a
Well, rip. Rip Hamilton with or without the mask?
Wit.
Always.
Okay.
Best one to ever wear a mask.
Oh, yeah, he was the one with the mask.
See this like grayish ray kind of come out, hit Roussel, just hold on to him and lift him 30 feet into the air.
Shit.
And you just see like Roussel's just like being grabbed. And then the second eye ray at you, Remy, is going to be a wisdom save again.
Abort.
20.
20. Nice. You passed. Nice. Good job. So,
those two damn good rolls.
And Ravens, man.
Very nice. Yeah, you saw this like pinkish black ray.
Ones are good.
And then this like really soft like orange light ray come at you, and you're just like, shoo, shoo. Dodging them both. Yeah, just your trench coat flailing in the wind.
Right.
Or billowing. All right. And now we'll go Draven.
All right. I'm going to peek out and try to lob a fireball at him.
So you gotta cast fireball. Nothing happens.
Do I kind of get a sense of what might have happened to me?
Make an intelligence check.
I think I kind of know after seeing three people do it, maybe, but I don't know.
That is 15.
Yeah, you notice he's looking at you. The other people you've seen, been looking at them.
Okay. Then I will.
And we'll do a legendary action.
Okay, well, he's up there.
Feels just so just.
He's gonna do a ray at Resell.
If we die, we can blame Toad.
Plan on it. All we need to bring was one hobo.
I don't know if that would have got.
He even asked for gifts.
Well, yeah, he brought the gift for me and wouldn't even tell you where it was. We weren't getting anything.
Right. Except another dead hobo.
I think we could have traded with him.
I don't.
Bring him two cows.
We were back there. We could have started looking.
And then I would have been eating.
Yeah. Come back and be like, oh, he actually did let him eat him. What the fuck?
Voluntary.
Alright, so.
Voluntary manslaughter?
So while Roussel's being held, you see this green ray fire out of one of them. Roussel takes 60 points of damage. You see this ray just slam into him. You see a piece of his armor just start to. There's like a beam sized hole in his armor.
Oh, not cool.
Better you than me.
It's Roussel's turn. He is restrained currently.
Fudge.
Necro.
Is he still alive?
Yeah.
Yeah.
He looks pretty hurt.
Yeah, I mean, he's level like 9, probably, level 10.
Mm-hmm.
He's been he's with us nine, for a minute. A
couple hits, though.
Well, that's.
Alright, Roussel's gonna fire a.
I think Drew's just tired of playing Roussel.
Oh, I got potions.
Can't put a potion in a guy with a hole in his chest.
Yeah, true that.
Ash. Wake up! You can be alive with half your skull? Get up!
Alright, so that's.
I still love you. Bruce, no. You I'll never say you go.
All right. You see yourselves going to start doing an incantation and put his hand over the hole, cast it, and you see just kind of like this green blackish energy just kind of wreath over him for a minute, like in a quick flash, and then go away.
You're on yourself, bub.
And then he's going to get targeted by another Iron.
I wish he... I can't wait until he gets to... if he survives.
Yeah, I don't know.
What's it called? That Hero's Feast. I don't know. They might not get Hero's Feast. It might just be Druids.
I think it's Druids, but I could be wrong.
Yeah, it might be just Druids.
Okay, so that's a con save.
Or scroll when you need them.
Jesus fucking Christ.
Huh?
One of the subclasses might, I don't know.
Yeah, so. Maybe a specific type of cleric. Yeah. Yeah, that's the cool thing about clerics is they have specific ones and you have a special list you get.
Yeah.
True that.
Really wish I would have prepared Magic Missile.
So, Roussel takes another 41 points.
Oh, no.
Oh, fuck.
But... he had just cast Death Ward on himself.
I was
going
to say, Death Ward,
so he
baby.
Stays at one hit point.
Holy shit.
I was just thinking that too, like he's
gonna... not today. Cast it again
as he's floating in the air.
Azur.
Oh god.
But I know can I that being in this guy's eyesight I can't do it.
Make intelligence check with advantage. I've seen it happen a few times.
17.
Yeah. You have noticed.
Actually 16 because I get a minus 1.
Yeah, you've noticed.
Okay. I'm going to attempt to go 5, 10,
15, 20,
25,
30.
Okay.
So I'm like just 10 feet behind him.
And you're going to cast.
I'm going to attempt a a lightning bolt.
Okay.
So Dex.
Lightning bolt.
Yes.
18.
It just passes. 17. Damn. 20. 32. 35. 38.
19, 17, 19.
Yeah.
Damn. All right.
Good roll.
So you
conjure
the lightning bolt, flies right through him. You see, as the lightning bolt like hits him and starts to pass through, just it doesn't ever appear on the other side, but it does hit him.
18 was my save DC.
Let's go.
Yeah, that's my turn. Sorry.
Legendary action here at you, Azur. Give me a wisdom save.
Yeah. 23. 23,
nice.
22.
22, still pass. You see that soft light, like orange ray, kind of fly towards you, but you're able to get out of the way.
That advantage in this shield is
being
huge right now. Because my other roll was really bad.
You're behind that pillar behind him.
Mm-hmm.
When you shoot this time, you will get your plus one from your... So you'll your full plus to hit.
Okay. I'll bonus action reload.
Okay.
Fucking drop the hammer on that bitch.
Why don't you even run your own character?
Run your character, bro.
I will take three shots at him.
He's not dropping any hammer. I don't even have a hammer.
20, a 19, and luck. And a 23.
20, okay, all three hit.
Nice. Mass.
Right.
5th level lightning bolt matched him.
And that's without action surge.
As you jump out, 3 shots, all 3 hit with their full force. You feel the
good work.
Your rounds fly out of the muzzle.
Nice boom.
With a little more velocity this time.
Got the kickback.
And then Nate.
Okay. I'm gonna use my bonus action to cast my mage hand up there to kinda fuck with them a little bit.
Okay.
You want to read that to you?
Yeah.
Okay.
Start poking one of his eye stalks.
So, as a bonus action, you can designate a creature within 5 feet of your mage hand to give you advantage on attack rolls against that creature until the end of the turn.
Okay. Okay, so it just gives you advantage, like the help action?
Yeah.
Okay.
So I'm going to lever my crossbow and take a shot.
Okay.
Uh, 19 plus 9.
Okay.
And then sneak attack does say once per turn, an attack with finesse or ranged weapon. So should get sneak attack on it also.
Okay.
Cool. And 7 more.
You fought this dude just in time for that ability.
38.
38,
nice. Yeah. Yeah. Finally, got something.
All three of us hit 38 exactly.
Should we cast that mage and you fire at him? Hitting him in the underbelly.
Which mine was half. But.
On this turn, it's his turn. At this point, the grasp on Roussel lets go and he falls 30 feet.
Shit.
Oh, no. He's unconscious.
Said, I'm sorry, Roussel.
Roussel
never
has
meant
dropped.
To make you cry tonight. I'm cleaning out the
courthouse. He hits the ground unconscious.
Trying to get a mage
down
roll.
There. Thank you. Appreciate you.
Fuck.
Okay, so from here, he's going to...
Oh, motherfucker. Oh, please don't turn around and stare at fucking Roussel. Please. Just go one-on-one with Draven. Fuck! No!
He's gonna float over there. He's gonna close his eye real quick and fire off three rays. We'll go... There, when he's hidden. So he'll go... where's that little coin I used to have? I stole from everybody. You still have that coin?
We both hit him, haven't we?
This?
Yeah.
You know what? One scissor.
Little
Kraken.
Kraken is.
Nate.
Dragon. Azur. So, ooh, Azur gets two, Nate gets one. So we'll go Azur first. Give me a con save, Nate. Give me a, what is that, deck save. And then Azur, give me a deck save.
22 on the con.
Okay.
Thanks for this advantage. Holy shit.
16 on dex.
And then a 23 for dex.
Okay. So your con, so you'll take none and none.
Yeah.
16.
Okay, and you take none. So you're all able to jump out of the way of these rays. Yes. He's going to open that eye back up.
And this shield is coming in freaking clutch for me,
okay.
Dude.
I'm going to toss a 6th level fireball.
Okay. Go ahead.
That is a death save.
Death save.
Death save. That is a 15.
Fail.
Nice. I'm just really worried about Roos right now. I'm gonna do it. I just don't think it's gonna, I don't know if it's gonna work. Or whoever gets there first, would it?
54.
Oh, nice. Yeah. Yeah, we got a meeting with the magistrate.
So as he turns his back, you just conjure up this massive fireball and launch it towards him, slams right into his back. You see him reel forward in pain.
And I will lay down behind that bruiser.
Okay.
You lay down in it?
Behind it. Take me.
Yeah.
Take me fire.
Said you didn't want it raw.
Yeah. Fortunately, he is 30 feet in the air. I can see you still.
Yeah.
It's a valiant attempt.
I'm trying to use my environment.
Yeah, it's just he's in the air.
Yeah.
So you'll have one come at you. For a deck save.
Oh, fuck. It's not a bad roll, but it's still a bad stat. 17.
17. That is a pass.
Woo!
Bad roll and you got a 17.
Yeah.
What are you talking about?
Well, I rolled 14 plus 3, so.
Your dex is higher than mine.
Oh, it is?
Yeah.
Do you have anything that turns it into no damage?
No. Unfortunately, I'm not cool.
No, you can just do 7th level and spells and have a ward up for like 70 extra hit points. And
yeah, everything
you got
else.
You got a 22 con.
You already fucking busted my ward.
I'm not cool, but I've got like 12 hobos as a shield in front of me. More than that. That would be the one I'd want in real life. Just give me a nice nice good shield in front of me, whoever wants to fight, you know? Oh, no.
I was really debating doing Disintegrate, but I was like,
right, so after it's half, you take decks. 33 points.
Ouch. Oh, shit.
God damn. Necrotic damage is that black and red ray fires towards you, hits you right in the ankle.
Ah! Fuck! That was my bad foot!
My Achilles!
My Achilles.
That's a 9-month recovery!
It's Roussel's turn. He'll make a death save.
If ever.
Oof.
Yeah. I just counted the squares.
Okay.
Somebody, yeah, get to him.
And after that, we'll launch another ray at you.
Oh, this fucking twat.
Another deck save.
God damn it.
He's been doing the same thing, though. He's been...
That's not great.
Keeping his eyes on everybody, then shooting 14. People behind him.
14, yeah, that feels...
Yeah. Yeah.
We might have a rip. The second rip of the... fight.
We can't let him rip.
So you take 58 points of necrotic damage as another black and red ray fires at you, slams into you.
Oh God.
And now it's Zer's turn.
I don't know what to do.
Catching the short end being over here by yourself.
Yeah. 5, 10, 15, 20,
25, 30. I'm 5 away from him.
Yeah, can't even get there.
I mean, what else are you gonna do?
I can't. I will attempt to bonus action Zephyr Flight.
Okay, you try and...
Nothing will work, right. Yeah.
Yo.
Let's out a toot.
Damn it, I always fought to give me a little extra boost.
Shit, in your general direction.
I was going to tell them... Do what you can. I'm going to dash the other way. Hydration. 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, 35, 40, 45, 50, 55. I just dash this way.
Okay.
To try to help out.
Try to get behind him.
Draven, to where we can split this.
Mm-hmm.
Split it 2 versus 2. To where...
That might work.
Well, all the magical folk are on the left side now, so... Oh,
yeah. I'm probably going to... die real fucking soon.
Yeah, that's why.
So at the end of your turn, he's gonna fire one more over at Draven.
I dashed over there.
No, you tried.
I was just stuck. I didn't. I mean, I really didn't have nothing to do. I would have
put. All right, give me a con save.
I would have put a potion in Roos's mouth, but I couldn't get there.
That is 20. All
right, you pass that as that purple ray kind of flies over. This time, it just slams right into that brazier.
Just tearing it to pieces.
Your eyebrows now are gone.
Whew. All right.
Thank Christ. I just need to get back to my turn.
Remy, you're up.
If I get to this.
Got all the movement.
I wasn't a guy. I couldn't get to him.
You can get to him in 25. But it's whatever you want to do, man.
Oh, yeah, you're right. Alright, I will pour a... What do I have here? A
superior potion of healing.
As you pop out that superior potion of healing, nothing happens.
We have to do it. We, you know, we.
I gotta try.
You gotta do it. Yeah.
No.
Any bonus action?
No.
Nate.
For a potion if he turns around.
Okay, yeah. So you pull out a potion, pop it open, yeah. And you're holding the action to, if he turns around, you're going to dump it in his mouth. Okay. Yep, you can do that.
Kind of huddle over him, see if he gets distracted.
Okay. Alrighty. Now it's his turn.
So fucked, man.
Alright, so the first one is... So much on this page. Constitution.
That's great. That's... damn near 30.
Okay, second one's Dex.
Jesus Christ. Fucking nervous.
And the third one's
Dex. That is 23, and the third one's Dex.
Mm-hmm.
That is 12.
12. That one fails. Okay, so this one is this grayish ray on the outside with like a soft purple core. It slams into your ankle, and you feel your body starting to feel tighter, you're restrained as your skin starts to harden, and it appears almost stone-like.
Oh no.
Shit. You are considered restrained.
Okay.
So that means you can't move, your speed's okay. Zero, and you can't benefit from any bonus to your speed. Attack rolls against you have advantage, your attacks have disadvantage. Okay, and you have disadvantage on dex saves. So you passed two, failed the last one. Okay, that's his turn. And we're moving to Draven. It's your turn.
All right. I'll slowly raise my arm up and point at him and cast Disintegrate.
All right.
It's seventh level.
It's a dex save?
Yeah.
That is 18.
God damn it. That just passes.
Oh, fuck. Now repeat your dex save, or excuse me, your... Yeah, so repeat the dex save, you have disadvantage now.
That is 15.
You continue to harden. Your skin loses its flesh full color as it completely hardens over and turns to stone.
Woo!
And he'll take a goddamn. Everybody's in front of him now.
Mm-hmm.
All right. Resell this save. That passes.
You definitely need Roos now.
Right?
He's the only one that can save you.
That's crazy. His plus just hit that.
He just passed.
That's nuts.
Yeah, he just passed.
13d6 plus 40. Damn. If I would have hit.
Alright, that's huge.
5, 10, 15, 20. Trying to take him out of one shot.
I look over at Draven. Does he?
You look back over there. Make a perception check.
Because I've been stoned before. 7.
Yeah. Looks like Draven hiding behind the brazier as best he can.
They're like, damn, he's standing really still.
Stone with fright.
Oh.
To be fair, the I think turning to failing the one that turned you to stone was better than failing the other one.
Yeah. Especially not getting disintegrated, because that would have just outright killed me.
Yeah. That's better.
Yeah. Not that I know what the other two were.
Right.
I can only assume one was.
Yeah.
Exactly. I'll cast a lightning bolt again.
All right. Is that Dex?
Dex, yeah.
Yeesh. Okay, 7.
Okay, Bill.
Can you roll that for me? Fucker would have been 15, dead.
19.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, you might
have
fucking smoked that. 29.
34. 41.
Hell yeah.
My second roll, I rolled a 6, 6, 5, 4. And then a 1. It's still 6, 6, 5, 4.
That's a lightning bolt. Mm-hmm. What level was it? 6.
5th.
Do you do it out of the bottom of your sword, or what do you do?
Yeah, I mean, I think I
lift it up.
Yeah, I think I just kind of like switch it around him and then kind of, you know, since he's forward, in the air, I kind of thrust
it
up.
Just like all that static from the blade just charging up and make its way to your gym as it gathers together and launches out, slams through his back again. You see, normally you're used to that lightning bolt going all the way through, and just on the other side of him, it doesn't ever come out. But you hit him for 41. Mm-hmm. God damn.
Yeah, I wrote a 6'5".
Starting to see tears in his flesh, electrical burns all over really him. Well. He's looking barely hurt.
Yeah, I feel like if they're on the ground, I feel like I shove it in the ground and it comes off. But if they're in the air,
he'll use a legendary action to target you with a ray.
Yeah.
Give me a deck save.
Yeah, I failed that one probably. With advantage for a 12.
Yeah, that fails.
What, a 7 and an 8 with advantage. I get half damage. I think it's just if I pass, I get no. Yeah,
I believe so.
Yeah, it is.
You take 54 points necrotic damage as that black and red ray slams into you. Try to get your shield up, but the ray makes it right over. Just hits you right in your fucking whipped cream top.
Dome.
Nice.
Remy.
So looking at us.
He's looking at y'all.
Okay, so I'm going to expend a grit point.
Okay.
To gain advantage on attack roll.
Okay.
And I'm going to shoot at him 3 times.
Nice.
You got a. Do I take off a point?
Yeah. Okay. Yeah, minus one.
Yeah. 27.
That hits.
28.
Yep.
And 20.
Okay. All 3 hit.
Go big damage.
That's for 33. And
thinking about axe surgeon?
Yeah.
Man, that fucking hammer.
Yeah, I'm gonna axe surge. Hurt. I get 3, correct?
Mm-hmm.
Do I still get my advantage?
No.
Okay.
You get 3 attacks. So you shoot 3 times, this bullet sink deep into his hide, he's bleeding badly. And you just muster up the courage to fire again 3 more times.
16.
That just misses. Or by a couple.
14.
That misses.
Look. 28.
All right.
Nice. Dude, that thing was at a 4. It was like,
that courage right on an 18, dude. It was like, down in his large eye. It just unnerves you a little bit. You missed the first two, but you managed to hit the last one.
13.
For 13.
Okay. Yeah, that's such a
And you fire it off.
Bad luck.
Yeah.
Your bullet definitely goes right through his main eye, out the back of his head. Blood everywhere.
Get that grip point back.
I get that grip point back.
Yes. Nice. Crashes down to the ground.
Yeah. I'm gonna
Your trigger goes off.
pouring my. I have a superior.
Hey, that was perfect time for grip. That dude, that sucker was at a 4.
Oh, no.
It was at a 4, yeah. And then the very last moment, bink, right on an 18. It was like 4, 4, 4, 4, 4, boom,
oh,
18.
Wow.
Because I'm like, no.
And I'm just frozen like
8d4.
Yeah.
How much?
I gotta get my dice out.
Gotta get your dice out, huh?
I'll get my dice.
Dice? What?
God damn it, I wish the disintegrate would have hit him. I would have smoked that turkey.
Yeah, you would have.
Right.
Would I hit him
God
for 56?
Damn.
46?
26.
So, yeah, you would have smoked him.
Not 265, 26.
I mean, close, because me and you together hit him for 80.
So he raises up, puts his hands on your shoulder.
Oh, yeah.
Thank you. Oh, you were on death's door there. Bruce.
I walk over.
Is everyone is everyone all right?
I don't know. Azur, how's Draven?
He's
walking over, taking a look at Draven. You see he's been turned completely to stone.
He's turned to fucking stone.
What?
He's turned to stone.
I feel like we've seen that before.
Shut up!
over there.
Should I kick him up? I'm gonna Eldritch Blast him.
Oh my god.
Break him into pieces.
He comes back with no ear.
Sorry, I'm trying to find the right spell.
Restoration?
Yeah,
greater,
it's greater.
Greater.
You know, I don't have that prepared.
Yeah.
I have Flame Strike, Mass Cure Wounds, and Raise Dead prepared.
Can you raise him?
So if we kill him, you gotta raise him, huh?
Get out don't the don't break him up while he's in that form.
Well, it looks like we gotta invite the guys in here to kill so we can walk Draven's statue out of here.
Well, we could just stay here.
We could just stay here.
I just need a day. Long rest.
I need a long rest anyway.
Well, let's go look.
It's already nighttime.
Yeah, it's nighttime.
Let's go look for this journal.
Are you starting to get the 8 hours rest in?
I think Draven's the only one gonna know what we're looking for.
Hey, well, we can at least look around.
We can go look around. We'll get a feel for the...
Just to throw it out there, I have the hat of disguise. I can become Draven.
You want to be Lord Blackmore?
I've got a knife for you.
Hey, does that mean that you would be the Lord Blackmore?
All right, everyone, is everyone hurt? Is anyone hurt?
I didn't even touch.
I got hit once for 55 or 65 or 56 or something, but I'm okay.
Missed three attacks.
Yeah, you're I'll be fine for now. I think you need to get yourself. What's more important is to get yourself, you know, back to normal, and I think we'll be okay. I'm hurting, but
going out with us the last couple months. It's really slowed your reaction speed down. You really took a beating there.
Yeah, that was rough.
Normally,
I literally don't have a scratch on me.
Well, not all of us are as dexterous as you, Nate.
Obviously. It's that clanky armor.
Yeah, it is.
Most spells, that armor deflects it, doesn't absorb it.
He's going to do a fourth level cure wounds on himself.
Should we take Draven with us while we look for this stuff, or you just want to put him next to
the put him next to the body of the beholder. We'll cut him open like a tauntaun.
Heals himself a little bit more. All right, y'all ready to go search through here?
Yeah, let's go searching through here. We'll leave Draven right there hiding.
All right, so I'll say, just for brevity here, y'all spend the next hour going through, searching through this place. You're not really finding much. It's all... The only room that was really kept nice was this main room. Everything else is dusty, decayed. Pieces of, like, parchment and shit you do find. Like, when you pick it up, it just kind of starts to crumble. The only other thing of note in this whole place is about the beholder size hole in the roof above the throne.
Okay.
I'm going to cast Fly on us.
Okay.
I can do 3, 4. I can only do me and 2 other people.
Leave Roos.
Leave Roos down here?
Yeah, to watch over. And then us 3 will fly up into there.
Okay. So flying up into here, you find... it's not like a huge, huge room. It's about probably 12-foot diameter. Inside, you find... like a big hammock in one of the corners that's like circular, where he clearly just sat himself in. You see like a couple of tables. It's weird that like one table is flipped upside down with like the 4 legs sticking up, and on each leg there's like something sitting on it. on one you see a fish bowl with a hamster in it. There's water in the bowl, but oddly enough the water is staying at the top of the bowl and the hamster's down below it. On one, there is just a glass eye sitting there. On another one, there's just a regular brass door handle. and on the 4th one, there's just a cup. Looking around the rest of the room, you see there's like another table set up. It's got like flowers and stuff set around it. Some like ornamental like gilding over it. And at the centerpiece of this is just a giant pencil.
Okay.
Seems to be one of his prized possessions. And then stuffed off in the in a corner, or not a corner, it's a circular room, but against one of the walls, there is this greenish black safe with chains all over it, all the same color with these big heavy padlocks on them.
I'm gonna walk up to that.
Okay.
Can I give it a feel? I'm gonna. Does it look like the padlocks take a key? Like
looking at them, you don't. See a keyhole, but you can make an investigation check.
I will do that. Uh, 16.
All right, so looking over it, just in an odd area of it, you do notice like a piece of it just kind of slides away, and then you do find a keyhole.
I'm gonna attempt to unlock the padlock.
Attempt, yes. Your expert lock picker.
16 plus 19.
Yep.
Bless.
So, 34.
Yep. So, 30 you unlock this 35. Padlock. There's 3 more padlocks on it. You can roll 3 more times.
Okay.
You'll get them all.
30?
Yep. DC's
25. Ooh. 22.
Oh, so you don't unlock one of them. Try again.
I'll try again.
Like your press for time?
Yes. 27.
Mm hmm. And the last one.
Okay.
32. Okay, yeah. So you unlock all of them. All the chains fall off of the outside of it, and now you have the number dial.
Ooh.
Yeah.
Got a number dial, huh?
Yep.
I'm going to try to like take a listen to it. It's been around a couple of times. Try to get a feel for it. And okay. I'm going to attempt to
go for it.
Unlock it. Nat 20. That's
39. Yeah. Jesus. You find it like damn near instantly. You open it up.
This is why Axton took lock in the first campaign, so he didn't do this shit.
And inside, skills. You find a small black notebook and a couple of other documents beneath it. They look old and frail.
How heavy is the safe?
The safe, you it just picking it up, you can't even like really pick it up by yourself. It's very heavy.
Okay.
Sorry.
I'm gonna get a piece of cloth out of my bag, and like put it over the book and kind of wrap it up and
okay.
Put it in my bag.
Okay. And then
Bless you. All that dust from that.
Yep. You open up.
It's all documents. And the other ones all look torn up and tattered.
They look old and they're still intact.
But okay. You imagine they require great care.
I'll leave them there for now.
Okay. Put them in the bag.
They look very delicate. I think if Draven wakes up, we can bring him up here to look at them if he would like to.
All right.
Can I levitate the papers and put them in the bag of holding?
Try. I feel like you think that's a delicate enough touch.
I mean, just because I don't touch them and I just get the bag and go over them.
Just magically lift up.
Okay.
You want to try it?
No.
Sure.
If you think you can get them in there, go for it.
Cast levitate?
Yeah.
And see. You lift up those papers, holding the bag holding open.
Yeah.
Inside.
Yeah.
Okay.
You know, just rest at this point?
Yeah. You just fly back down and rest.
All right.
We'll get Draven to check out the room tomorrow if we can get him awake.
Let's manage these spells. Let's unprepare.
What are we going to do about homies in the front?
Maybe they've had a guard change by then.
You think anybody comes in here?
Would you?
But would you, when they say, it's your gang.
Maybe we go tell him we had a meeting and he flipped out on us. I mean, he may have been a benefit to them, but I don't know if they're actually working with him in any capacity.
Guess we can tell him. Frenic Driscoll told us to go kill him.
All right. So after this long rest, Cell starts to pray in the morning. Drops Flame Strike, walks over to Draven, and casts Greater Restoration. The stone begins to crumble away, and life returns to your memory. Just taste a bunch of shit in your mouth.
Pants him. Yeah.
Why?
Push him.
Stick
over.
A flag in his asshole. Yeah. Stand on him.
About time you came back to the land of the living.
Oh God! It wasn't by choice that I got turned to stone.
You didn't choose not to.
It looked like you were celebrating it.
My entire body's fucking hurts.
You could have hit him with that green streak of energy, but you missed.
Trust me, I tried.
Rousseau finished him for you.
Hit.
Well, good news.
My fucking building.
I mean, bad news.
You still don't have your long rest.
Yeah. 17 hit points.
Ooh. How much?
17.
Damn.
I think I found the book we were looking for.
Oh, good.
But there's a lot more stuff up there. Seems like junk, but might want to take a look around.
Yeah, just give me a moment. Then after like 15 minutes, I'll collect myself and cast the... I cannot cast fly because I don't have it prepared. Anybody would like to whisk me up there?
You know, fly him on up.
I'll cast fly after the long rest.
On who?
Draven.
Okay, so fly up there.
Yeah, and I'll sit down and start ritually casting detect magic.
So take your 11 minutes.
So as your aura goes off, the only thing in this room, or I guess the two things, the bowl with the hamster in it and the water above, that's giving off a magical aura there, and the eye.
Okay. I'm going to get real close to the eye and cast Identify on it.
Okay, cast Identify on it, and I can't remember the exact item name. Basically, if you lose an eye, pop that sucker in and it works.
Oh, cool.
Requires attunement.
Pick that up and throw it in the bag. And okay. I'll also pick up the hamster bowl.
Okay.
I don't want him to die in here.
He's up there like, drinking a little bit of the water.
Bring him with us. Fly back down.
Well, I got to cast fly again. A second time.
It only lasts 10 minutes.
Oh, yeah. We were up there at least 30.
Just jump. I'll cast Feather Fall.
Yeah, you could.
Yeah.
You come back down.
Yeah.
Grab the eye, got the bowl with the hamster. You take a look at the book, or...
Yeah, I'll pull that out. I got it wrapped up, and found a couple more papers. You want to bring those out, too?
This is probably honestly the best time, just in case if what happens last time, I'll be easier to put down.
This is true.
Kick that camera. All right, so you pull the book, bring the papers out, cast Levitate on them. Mm-hmm. All right.
I'll look over the papers first.
Okay, looking over those papers, it's a lot of the ink has faded.
Mm-hmm.
But what you get the idea is she's a heretic. She was cast out for her heretical stance.
So these are the court notes of everything that transpired.
Yeah, a lot of it's, you know, like I said, faded and gone. But you can kind of read over it and get an idea that she was a high wizard. She was always interested in, you know, the occult, different things. Always getting in trouble for going outside of the norm. Then she started preaching this whole theory about this land beyond the sky there. It was deemed heretical. She was cast out, and she left by ship to the south. They took her book and locked it away, citing that it was just the scribbles of a madman or a madwoman. So it was proof of her madness. It talks about how she had worshipped this great worm.
Uh-oh.
They had a, and here, this is like an ancient form of the language, but basically you're getting a, it translates to the way they have it written as like the Y, or W-Y-R-M. Like worm dragon.
Right.
So yeah, that's what you get from it. You want to take a look at the book?
Beforehand, I'm actually going to make a makeshift gag.
Okay.
And put it in my mouth and tie it off just so I can't cast any verbal.
Okay.
Components.
I got you. Preparing.
Yep.
Okay. So opening up this book.
You don't immediately get mad.
Looking in it, looking over these like vellum pages, they're filled with like these deep scratching scribbles, like just all over the place. You see like
madness.
Yeah, you see these crazy disturbing images. You see people with like their faces like melting off and limbs removed and like, you know, arms, legs removed. They look like they're just crawling on the ground. You see just numbers all over the place, just like upside down, backwards. On another page you just see these like random like runes like sketched into it, like real deep and crazy, just at random
carved into the paper.
Mm-hmm. But give me an arcana check here.
Nice, natural 20.
What they say, I was like, shouldn't we wait until tomorrow when you
have
luck left?
That would be 30.
30, okay. So actually looking at these runes, they look like they're mad and all over the place, but you do manage to find a pattern, and this is the sigils to a teleportation circle.
Wow.
Well, boys.
That was a DC 25.
Wow.
Figured that out.
Very cool.
Goddamn.
Ray looks like a kid at Christmas.
Anything interesting in that book, Draven?
Very interesting,
I'm
actually.
Fucking bored, man. What'd you find in there? You've been looking at that
bitch for a while.
I found
a great deal about this ancient occult, about a great worm, but not worm in the typical sense, like the dragon. And it just talks about her madness and these court archives. And then in this book here, if you take these pages out, and I start kind of pulling the pages out and laying them down where it matches in the teleportation circle.
Okay.
Without infusing it with the weave, I just leave it there. And I'm like, it presents a teleportation circle.
To hell?
I don't know. I would assume it would be the Sea of Stars.
Wonder where that
is. What she believed it to be.
I think my adventure days are over.
What happened to her after the
retiring?
It says that she was, her tome was taken, and that she set sail to the south.
The south. What is south?
Well, I would assume
the hills. Since
she discovered this teleportation circle, she probably just got it out of reach and then just used that at some point.
Do you believe she's mad, or do you believe this was more of a hidden, you know?
I would say with everything going on, she was very entangled with the occult, and not that she was mad, but she was obsessed. From what I can tell. If that makes any sense.
Well, it sounds mad.
Yeah. I mean, I get pretty mad when I get obsessed over, you know, things.
If you would like, we could adjourn this for tomorrow while I go and lick my wounds, and we could investigate this further.
Maybe we should
get out of the magistrate's house?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
I can try to smooth this over. With
some coin?
Coin would probably be come in handy.
Will you actually use the coin, or are you going to pocket the coin?
I'll use it if it's needed.
Mm-hmm. Blackheart, Blackmore. There's
no way this stays a secret for long, so I think we probably best to get out ahead of it.
Can I... while they're talking, look at the beholder and see if there's anything of arcane value to harvest.
You want some brain?
Some beholder brain. Maybe if you could get just kind of, what would you call that? Like the sinew and his eye stalks. Maybe that might make a good core.
Mm. Okay.
Well, give me a survival check to extract it.
A second survival, probably.
It goes off.
I can try. Give
me survival.
Okay.
If you want to do survival to help him, and you can add your Arcana check in there.
Okay.
It takes a little bit.
So you need
a
roll?
Mm-hmm. If you're going to help him.
Yeah.
You do the cut and he does the, you need this part.
I'm not bad. 18?
Yeah. So you're able to get a perfect piece out of there. This might make a great core.
Wrap it up and put it in the bag of holding for the time being.
All right.
One.
That was beholder disgusting.
Eye stalk.
Yeah, it was real gross.
For masturbation.
It's all slimy.
For masturbation purposes.
Okay, what are you doing now?
A teleportation circle?
You gotta rest.
Yeah.
I think we should go to the
I need club. To try to smooth this over.
Should we teleport out of here so we don't have to deal with more guards and I go down?
I think Federation is fine.
We need to go see Borba and see if she got that to Frenic or not, too.
I think we should go to the Federation in Driscoll.
If y'all go ahead and go to the Federation and Driscoll.
Well, no, I'm talking about. Are you gonna walk out?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, so you want us all to walk out?
No, y'all can teleport to the other
okay.
place.
That's, okay, and then fine. We'll meet back at the business. End.
I'll do mine.
Okay.
So you cast teleportation circle. Y'all gonna teleport back to the Federation building in Driscoll?
Yes. Mm-hmm.
Okay, and you're gonna walk out. Mm-hmm. So you walk right out the door. They're gone. Are you going with Nate or are you teleporting?
I'm teleporting.
Okay. So y'all three go. And you walk out, guard's gonna turn around. So, how'd it go?
It didn't really go great.
You made it. Did he kill your friends?
He attempted to kill us all.
A lone survivor?
Well, no. There are other survivors. It's just, the magistrate himself. Didn't survive this one. So I think we need to go see the Eye.
Yes, the boss will probably want to see you over that one.
Yes, I figured so.
Well, good luck. Hopefully she's in a good mood.
Do I need an escort? Yeah, I know the way.
Yeah, just... I'll give you this one. Go ahead.
Okay. And I'll go.
All right. You go see her?
Yeah.
All right, so you make your way to go see Edola. Or the eye. Nathaniel. What brings this visit?
Well,
more good news, I hope.
I want to go to a different inn.
We don't stay at this inn, do we? I didn't think we stayed at this inn.
Not this inn. It's like an inn down the road.
Yeah.
Anyways.
Sorry.
Continue.
Make sure we don't all die. Just Nate.
Well, this news isn't as cheery as the last time we spoke.
Huh.
I had a meeting with the magistrate overnight.
Interesting. And the bad news is all your friends died.
No, they survive.
The bad news is you were horribly maimed.
The magistrate did not.
The magistrate.
We tried to bargain with them, and you know, this crazy nature, he wasn't going to be happy unless he had all of our blood.
Nathaniel, we go way back. We've been around each other for a while, but this is damn near unforgivable. He was a very important piece to our operation.
No one else knows of this.
No one?
Except the two guards out front.
Okay.
Oh, no, lady.
Okay.
Extra, extra, mattress is dead!
Well. No one knows except for them two. Okay. We can still keep the threat of the magistrate alive. All right. Just trying to gather her
emotions. How much gold did I get to bring with me?
Whatever you wanted.
How much we got in there?
We'll consider this a new debt. Complete some tasks for me.
Probably not.
We can work this off, and it all stays contingent on no one finding out that the magistrate's dead. So your first task will be to tell the two guards to report to me immediately.
I can do
tell them I want to get their report on what occurred. Actually, I'll have someone go get them. I won't send you. But I will call on you for a time, and maybe another time, and another time, and make this right. If anyone ever finds out that the magistrate is dead, we'll come for you.
That is understandable and kind of you. So far to give me this chance to repay this slight.
Yes, it's part of the backbone of our enforcement. You know, part of it. People feared the magistrate.
Speaking of things I can do for you.
Yes.
How high are the aspirations you would see yourself ascending to here in Driscoll?
What's your implication in this? Speak straight.
If the head of state can be removed, would the power vacuum be a place where you could profit?
That's certainly a role I could fill. I would consider the debt paid if you can make that happen.
I think we have an understanding.
All right. Well, until better times.
Again, my apologies.
Well, you always manage to find a way to make it right.
All right. Take off.
All right. Let's take a quick break here.
Okay.
You
will I be able to take a long
rest? I knew we should have done this secretly.
Yeah. Okay, cool.
You just tried to be straightforward?
I mean, what's the gain of trying to run?
Right.
Schmear campaign. Bringing those two guys in and killing them, and then us just vamping out.
Or sneaking in there.
No, we could just kill them.
I'm just saying.
Were they the same guards?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. I'm sure they had shift change, told those guys, hey, these guys are in here.
Yeah. It was a full day or so, so probably we're gone and back.
Okay.
Yeah. Take a quick break.
Yeah.
Teleportations.
Yeah, we're back.
Short break.
Go for it. So y'all take a long rest.
Yes.
Wake up the next day feeling well rested.
Sorry, I slept through the rest of the day. How did it go with your HQ?
I think we need to kill Fernick Driscoll.
I just start laughing.
Are you serious?
Yes. Luckily, I'm still alive. It was, she's not pleased, but she does seem supportive of the idea of, opening a power vacuum here in Driscoll. Maybe we can take care of our own problems.
Who?
While aiding the eye in this.
What's the penalty for, non-compliance?
Our heads.
Okay.
She's gonna kill all of us.
Well, I mean...
Probably.
I may not hold my tongue if I get tortured.
I mean, she's not... She's seen all of us together.
Yeah, I know. I'm pretty sure she knows
the Black Company.
Doing this, yeah.
Who are we going to put in power after...
That will be her decision.
Nate. Two Blackmores, two cities, powerhouse.
But, you know, if you've got a teleportation circle you want to disappear to, I think if we can make this happen with Frenick, disappearing would probably be the best.
You talking about taking Frenick with us in the teleportation circle?
No, killing him and disappearing for ourselves.
Well, can't we... What we need to do with Frenick is accidentally take him to our scouting mission to hell.
Take him on a hunting trip like we did the last one.
I mean, you know, like...
We might be having...
Didn't you do that to somebody recently, the golem?
Well, that was slightly different.
What's an easier way to kill somebody than to just... Poof! They're in the depths of hell.
You're right. But... Kind of, how are we going to get back to him?
That's what I was thinking.
Since
so
we've already shown that we can show up to his bedroom once, I'm sure he's increased
you only
security.
We have Borba hopefully transporting a product into the into his room. Maybe we can poison that product, or...
How long does it take you?
I would suggest something like that, because that would belittle his name in the long run of... Poisoning the drug, having it found on him, making it look like an OD, and tarnishing his name while we're at it.
Right.
For it, how long does it take you to cast that teleportation circle?
About a minute. Or are you talking about my planar shift?
No, just your normal get out of jail.
That's about a minute.
Okay. Yes, we could If the poison doesn't work, I totally support that idea. Rather like it. Sneak in backhanded. Yeah.
You know? That's always the option. Those. It's always the fun option.
Sneaky and backhanded.
You are, that's exotic. You are quite familiar with poisons. Is there a player's choice one might use for a situation to lace a narcotic with?
I could go searching through the alley and see if I can find something that'll work.
All right.
I mean, you can change the way you look, correct? Can you change the way your voice sounds?
I believe me and him can.
Yeah, can I can too.
Thorley, King Thorley, Weston. Can you be him?
I could, but I would prefer not to drag him into this.
He won't know that you're dragging him into it. You could say, "I'm on my way. I think we have some potential business plans to Blackmore."
But there will definitely be guards that know that he walked into that room.
Yes.
Well, I'm just.
It would be hard to cover a paper trail.
I think we can.
That.
We can get in. Getting out's gonna be harder. But.
Well, there always is the mention door, maybe.
I think we need to do some research on his main bodyguard.
I think this is one of those situations, and there's very few of them where we need to split the party on this and kind of have one man heading this. Which I would assume to be you.
Okay, I will say this. Do we need to focus on Frenic or the mystery teleportation circle first?
I wouldn't mind getting our names cleared in Driscoll real quick and then letting them start do their thing.
Right.
I'm fine with it. I'm just
or
saying,
we can go poison the traveler's dust and then head off.
Yeah,
come back and see what happens, I guess.
Because I doubt Borba has come and visited him since the last time.
You can think of one off the top of your head. It's called Midnight Tears.
Okay.
I ingest it, and nothing happens until midnight. And that midnight
takes effect. Okay.
But there's no trace of the
poison
necessarily.
That's what I was gonna say. Personally, I think
you can trace any poison if you're trying to poison them.
Right.
I think we can possibly.
I just didn't know if there was a way to check someone for
when people are proficient with medicine.
Okay.
I mean, maybe a large amount of another drug may help.
His skin is purple and his eyes are big.
Give him too much of the traveler's dust.
Or you could disguise yourself as Borba and do it yourself.
We know what happened last time. Somebody disguised himself as Borba.
Well, that's what I was saying. Because if we keep,
it did work.
If we go back to. We gave Borba stuff a week ago. We bring her more this week. We go teleportation the next week. We see how, in Frenic is with the drug. Because it might take him a week or so to really get ramped up to taking it every night.
And outside of Draven, I don't know if this stuff is cut, where it's 2080, or if it's pure shit or what, because maybe you can just give him pure shit and that fucking OD him,
So how long do you think we can make it without them knowing the magistrate's dead?
Well, they...
I think the magistrate's gonna be...
The people that know the magistrate, the person that knows the magistrate already knows that he's dead.
I don't think that's gonna get out.
Officials and Driscoll know
Right. But I wouldn't imagine taking that long.
I think about a couple of weeks, I think. A
couple of weeks?
Yeah,
maybe so.
I would say it would be a good idea to let him get hooked on it and then come back and kind of...
He's going to bring Borba more of the Traveler's Dust.
Mm-hmm.
And then teleport. Is that what you're saying?
Yeah, I think so.
And after we
get
him
hooked on it, give him a while, and then come back and...
Okay.
And then we focus on
then we'll really
ass.
Discern if we want to poison or if we want to try to OD by force or what.
By that time, we might have some more magic powers that can help us get into the castle better, too.
Okay. So, we'll say...
We have, maybe...
I'll run back to Borba, give her more of it.
Oh, you like this.
Did you give it to him already?
Yes. A few nights ago.
Did you personally give it to him, or did he put it in his own eye?
I dropped it in his eye.
Nice.
Say we poison this crap right now, because it's over with, man.
Whatever. My only concern with the poison too. Is the poison coming back on someone who does know what they're...
What are you talking about there?
Oh, sorry. I was... nothing.
Orba, come here. I think Azir wants to fuck you.
Ooh, finally!
Talk amongst yourselves.
Give me that blue carrot.
That would be my only concern.
Next time.
Being away at being traced.
All right.
To an outside source.
So you go back to town. You'll get ready to teleport.
Yeah. I mean, it gives us...
Sorry, go ahead.
Yeah.
I'm just saying, I think it just gives us a couple of days to do what we need to do, and then
really
we get this done
on,
in a 10-day, you know?
Yeah. Let's go. Really decide on how we're going to do it.
I got an idea. I just can't do it until my next level.
Because it took us like 2 weeks before we decided how we were going to kill that other guy, just because we made sure everything was planned out. So let's make sure we plan everything out again.
I will kill that motherfucker. Just give me all time.
Right. So, teleporting. Lay out the sigils.
Yep.
Start casting teleportation circle. Starts to spin. That light comes up out of it. You all step through.
Yep.
Yeah.
Fade to black.
You find yourself in complete darkness.
Shit.
With dark vision, you can see out about 60 feet. You see that you're inside of some kind of old building. The smell in here is putrid. And that's where we'll leave off.
Nice.
We will pick up again next time. We upload all our videos to YouTube at Iron Lich Gaming. You can get a link down below. I don't even know what the dashboard looks like anymore, or the channel looks like anymore, because they keep changing shit.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, let's see what the channel looks like now. Make sure I'm still describing things properly.
Whew. We wanted to take them out for a while.
Yeah, so you can click on that video on demand tab there. That'll take you right to the playlist. Catch our next video, or tonight's video tomorrow on there. Stream Fridays at 7:30-ish.
7:30-ish.
7:40.
11-ish. Very-ish.
Rough times.
On
time.
Just plug in us, and then it, you know, bings to your phone when we get on. Just 7:30, 7:45.
Make sure you subscribe on Twitch, or follow on Twitch. Give us, you can subscribe here, too, if you want. And no one's here, so...
Just us.
Just us. All right. We'll catch y'all next time.